This is the Segway app for the Segway Navimow. The particular robot I have is the i-series. You could see it up here in the corner doing its thing. So you can see all of that darker color is where the Navimow has cut. And then if it hadn't, it would be this lighter gray color. And you can see I have selected to have my zone 2 up there cut while zone 1 does not. And then you can see these red icons there. Those indicate no-go zones that I set up. On the main screen here, you have a few options. You can see mowing right now. It's manually mowing. It's going out. You've got a Wi-Fi indicator, a Bluetooth indicator, battery indicator. You can lock and unlock your Navimow right from here. Progress of how much it's cut. You can see it's 99%. How many, in this case, square feet this particular week I have cut. And then down here we can start, stop, and there I accidentally paused the mower. So we're gonna tell that to start up again. And then I could send it home to charge if I wanted to. Here we could see it's charging now. If I select control, I have to be within Bluetooth range. I'm not. But if I select my map icon right here, it's gonna show me zone 1 and zone 2. It's giving me a notification that my Bluetooth is kind of weak, but this is how I can edit my maps and or add more things such as no-go zones and other zoned areas if I want. So I'm gonna quit anyway since I didn't make any changes. And then up here, we're gonna see, here's a notification that it's done, it's back at the charging station. Over here on the right-hand side, we have all the notifications from the system. So I had a couple error codes while I was testing something. We also have access to our system notifications. So allow notifications, system notifications, device notification, important work status, show on homepage. That's all from there. Here they have their technical support, but the main crux of what you're gonna pay attention to is over here on the left. This is all of our settings. So right here we have the settings for the mower, and then tapping over, we have the application. So account security, language, units, help and feedback, about, and then log out of your account. We're gonna come back to our mower, and then right there, we did get a notification saying, hey, the mower is returning and progress is done, so it's going to go charge. On our mower settings, if we come down, we have our mow schedule. I do have a schedule enabled, but I don't actually have anything turned on at the moment. But in order to turn one of these on, you simply select, and then you can set a time, and then all zones, zone 1, zone 2 in my case, and then confirm. What that will do is send the robot out during that time to mow. It's not start, and then when the job is done, it will stop. It's during the time that you've selected that it will mow during. I don't know if I particularly care for that, but that is how Segway handles it. Here we have most cycle. You could turn this on and off. When this is disabled, if the mowing progress in the selected area reaches 100%, regardless of if it still has more mow time, it will return to the station to charge itself. I recommend that because you don't necessarily want it just hanging out cutting and cutting when it's already done what it needs to do. Here we have our map management, anti-theft on and off. So this is an extra thing that you need to add on. So if you don't have it, can't use it. You have your reset pin, so you can confirm your reset pin. Personalization, if I select this, do we want to have the lights on? Do we want to have the sound effect? And do we want to have eco mode? If I turn on eco mode, when enabled, the lights on the mower and the charging station and display screen will turn off automatically after the mower goes into standby mode for 10 seconds. And then here you have night mode, which will set the brightness level of the mower's light. And here you can see before and then after, and then you've got your brightness level, extra dim and dim. I want to keep it as low as possible to not bring attention to it while it's out there doing anything. Vision fence, channel sense means that when it's traveling from one zone to another, it will avoid anything that's in the channel. So if there's something in the channel, it will move outside of the channel and get back into the channel as quickly as it can to get from position to position. And then you have the ability to mowing at night. When enabled, the mower will keep working at night, as you might imagine. Maybe you don't want that because, well, you live in a region like I do where the temperature shifts and things get wet and moist overnight. You can turn that off right there. Coming down, we have our EFLS2. Well, here we go. It's going to give us some information. Camera assisted positioning. Yes. Satellite signal analyzer. If I do that, it's going to click and it will show me satellites, letting me know how good a chance I have that my mower is going to connect with something. I really like that, the fact that you can just come in here and take a look, and it's showing you a little more extra information. And then lock time. So if I go analyze, it's going to tell me how long it takes the mower to lock on to a satellite. And here we see the results. I have fast, so that's good, based on satellites and how fast it locks. I'll have no problems with my robot mower. And then antenna location finder. This would be a way for you to figure out best place for you to put your antenna. Weather adaptive, you can turn that on and off. The sensitivity, drizzle up to a moderate rain. And then how long do you want it to delay? So I could say won't wait, or I do custom. And in my case, I did custom and told it to wait for 6 hours. Now, here's the thing. There are no rain sensors on the i-series of the Segway Navimow. It is based entirely on weather data for your particular area. So I was out there dumping buckets of water on my Navimow to try and get it to go into a rain delay state, forgetting that it was not based on actual contact sensors, but weather data. So this makes the weather delay hit or miss it for its actual usability in my case. Here we could say relocate charging station. I only moved the station. I moved the RTK antenna. That's where you could go and fix that network. Well, 4G or your Wi-Fi. Here you could see based on where I have it, it has a Wi-Fi signal, but not the greatest firmware. So it's going to give you a lot of sensitive information. So I'm not going to show you that. Coming down to mow reports. This is going to give you the total area that has been mowed, the total time saved based on how long it's gone out there, and then information on mows. Now, this should have information because I just sent it out there today to do this while I started filming. But if I bring this over to weeks, it will show how many times I mowed zone one, how many times I zone mow two, work area, and then mow hours. And if I select this, it's going to give me a chart letting me know when I sent it out to do the most work. And then if I come over to the month, it's going to be very similar. Mow hours and then locations. I do wish that if I clicked on this, it would bring up a calendar rather than having me pick out the day. But that's splitting hairs. Parts and maintenance, I like this too because here I can see exactly how long the blade life is based on 24 hours remaining, they're at 30%, and then chassis parts, which is pretty much like, hey, you should go out and clean the sensors and everything, and I can say cleaning done, and the timer will start over. Here you can see I've used it for equivalent of 56 hours, and same thing with the blades. So there's 24 hours remaining before it recommends changing the blades. Coming down, we have more settings. So I've got basic info right here. If I select this, it's going to give me personal information. So we're staying out of there. Time zone. Here is my time, location, and then auto daylight savings. And then I can unbind the device if I ever give this to somebody. Here we have device sharing, which I can share the device and then switch and or add a device. So I can add a device from here. And we're going to come back to the front because that's everything that we can do for the Navimow i-series using the Navimow app.